Start in the morning. If you understand the times, the Bible says in the book of Genesis, the evening and the morning was the first day. It wasn't the morning and the evening. You know what it means? You might be in the night season of your life, but baby, you're already in the new day. It might seem like it's midnight, but you're already in the new day. Do not make a mistake and look at the darkness on the outside. Look at the light that is breaking forth on the inside. Come on. And in this time of Herod, there was a priest named Zacharias. Zacharias means God has remembered. And his wife, her name was Elizabeth. Elizabeth means the oath. So God put Elizabeth and Zachariah together. so that he could remember the oath. God knows how to align people in the earth. Oh, come on now. What was the oath? That he was going to send a deliverer. God knows how to marry the right people. God sends you to the right church so that the people on the top can unlock what's inside of you. That's why you can't sit in the wrong place. There's somebody that's got a key that unlocks your destiny. Come on now. Somebody's configured with something to take you to your next level. Oh, come on. Her name was Elizabeth. Say Elizabeth. They were both righteous before God and walking in his commandments and ordinances before the Lord, and they were blameless. Everybody, can you read verse number 7? I'm reading from the King James. Verse number 7. But they had no child. Isn't this the picture of the church? Picture of the church. We're doing everything right. We prayed, we fasted, but we failed to give birth to a next generation. We failed to give birth to something. Our wombs are empty. Oh, come on now. We're singing, but our wombs are empty. We're preaching, but our wombs are empty. We have failed to produce. Oh my God. Because you must remember, this was preceded by 400 years of silence. There was no prophetic voice. And all of a sudden, God started to create something. God started to move in the earth. And he says, I'm going to remember my oath. I'm going to remember the prophecy that I spoke through the mouth of Isaiah that says there's coming one that will make straight the way. You see, what we are doing in this generation, we are picking up prophetic words that were spoken by men of old in other generations. The Bible says they now in the cloud of witnesses, but they can't, oh my God, they did not see it because God had something better in store for us. So we pick up mantles, we pick up mandates, anointings from previous generations. Ooh, my God. And the Bible says they had no child. Listen to this. And it came to pass that while he did his priestly offices before God, as he always did, according to the custom of the priests, his lot was to burn incense. And he went into the temple of the Lord. And a whole multitude of people that were praying outside at the time of incense. Let me tell you something. The prayer cloud over this generation is heavy. There's our Tannies that have been praying for us. Those people that have been pushing Friday nights on their knees. Intercessors, grannies, granddads been praying. The prayer cloud is heavy. Somebody in this generation is going to penetrate that prayer cloud and bring down the glory rain of God's presence on this generation. The Bible says the people were praying on the outside. And there appeared an angel of the Lord standing on the right side of the altar. And when Zechariah saw him, he was troubled and fear fell upon him. But Zechariah said, the angel of the Lord said to him, "Fear not, Zechariah, for your prayer has been heard. And your wife Elizabeth shall bear a son. And you shall call his name John." You must remember, this was church folk that only knew the law. They did not know the grace of God, because the name John means grace. And that word was the first time, the name was first time mentioned when the angel of the Lord spoke it. I want to prophesy something, that we're going to speak things that no other generation before us has spoken. We're going to unlock mysteries that has been hidden from every other generation. The Bible says that Zechariah said, "How shall I know that this is the word of the Lord?" And the angel of the Lord said to him, "Listen, I come from the presence of God. And you want to know how you're going to know it's from God? You're not going to be allowed to speak." Can I also say something? What God is about to do, not even us, men and women of God, is allowed to speak against it. God said, "Zechariah, I'm going to shut you up." Sometimes if you don't understand what God is doing, say nothing. Don't speak against what God is doing. Is there anybody here tonight? Don't open your mouth if you don't understand. And Zechariah, for the first time, supernaturally at the word of the angel, he goes to his Elizabeth, and she falls pregnant. While this is happening, the Bible says for 5 months, she hid herself. Five is the number of grace. She hid herself. See, when God is doing something with you, don't expose it before it's time. When God wants to do something in your life, you got to keep it sometimes. You can't tell the wrong people. The wrong people will abort what God wants to do in your life. Come on now, come on, come on, come on. Sometimes you got to learn to shut up. Look what happened to Joseph when he spoke his dream before his time. Look at your neighbor, say, keep quiet, keep quiet, keep quiet, keep quiet, keep quiet, keep quiet. The Bible says, listen, the Bible says that for 5 months, she hid herself. But in the sixth month, look at your neighbor, say, the sixth month. 6 months is a month of visitation. The Bible says in the sixth month, listen, the angel of the Lord that visited Zechariah goes to another lady. This time she's not an old girl. This time it's a young girl. Oh my God. She's someone that a man has not yet touched. You see what God is about to do. No man can have glory or share in what God is doing. Mary was not touched by a man. Oh my God. The first person, the first man that penetrated Mary did not penetrate her from the outside in. He penetrated her from the inside. Because what God is about to do starts internally. It's not starting on the stage. It starts internally. Angel of the Lord visits Mary and says, Mary, you have found favor in the sight of God. And I'm going to make you pregnant. Oh, Mary says, but how can this thing be? I do not know a man. Can I put it in 21st century church language? How can this thing be? I don't even have a ministry yet. Yet you're telling me, you're calling me for the nations. I don't have any contacts in America. How can this be? You're telling me I'm going to speak in stadiums? I don't have anybody. Mary said, I do not have him. I don't know. I don't have a man. And the angel of the Lord responds to her and he says, for the Spirit of the Lord, Mary, shall come upon you. What happened tonight? When we begin a worship at the beginning, what was happening? The Spirit of the Lord was coming upon you. Every time you're truly touched by the Spirit of the Lord, you should be falling pregnant. If you're really touched, not the shabababa touched. I'm talking about a real touch, because you cannot be intimate and walk out with an empty womb. Every time you forget intimate, you walk out with something inside of you. That's why we can't have soulish praise and worship. That's why we cannot sing in the flesh. That's why we got to get intimate. Get on the bed again. How shall these things be? The Spirit of the Lord will come upon you. I can just imagine this young girl thinking about her future. What am I going to do? How is it all going to work? And the angel of the Lord says, don't ask any more questions. She responded and said, I don't understand it, but be it unto me according to your word. What God is about to do in your life, what God is doing in your life, you don't have to understand it. You just got to comply. You got to comply. You got to just be in agreement with what God is saying. Listen, the biggest challenge for Mary was not that she was going to fall pregnant. The biggest challenge for Mary was, how was she going to explain it? The same angel that goes to Mary goes to Joseph. This is now recorded in the book of Matthew, chapter number 1, from verse 20 onwards. The angel of the Lord goes to Joseph and says, Joseph, this is your girlfriend. And Joseph, the baby's not yours. You see, what we are carrying right now, what we are pregnant with, does not belong to any denomination, does not belong to any man, does not belong to any group of churches. It belongs to God. It was born of God. Take your hands off what God is doing. Take your hands off. Look at your neighbor and say, take it off, take it off, take it off, take it off, take it off. Sit down. Joseph, listen to the four instructions. Listen to the instructions from the angel of the Lord. Joseph, you're not going to put her away. That means you're not going to be ashamed. When the people start to scream and roll in your meetings, don't be ashamed. Some people get uncomfortable in the move of God. Let me tell you something. What's order for man is chaos for God. And what's chaos for man is order for God. What might look chaotic for you is God at work. Sometimes our churches have too close much of a program for even God to get in. He said, Joseph, you're not going to put her away. You're not going to be ashamed of her. But you're going to protect her. Every true man of God will protect the move of God. Every true woman of God will protect the move of God. The next thing, Joseph, you're going to do, you're going to pay for it. The baby's not yours, but you're going to pay for it. God is raising up people to pay for the move of God. God's going to put you all on planes and send you to stadiums. And people are going to pay for what God is doing through you. Somebody's got to receive this tonight. So there's the established church with Elizabeth and Zechariah. There's an emerging church with Mary and Joseph. And at the same time, the established church is pregnant and the emerging church is pregnant. Can I prophesy? This is that time we're living in right now. There's an established company, the men and women of God, that has pioneered great moves of God. They have fallen pregnant again in their old age. It seems like God is refiring mandates. God is putting new anointing, fresh vision upon mandate. And there's a new company of young people. I said there's a new company of young people. There's a new company. They are the Marys of God. They are the emerging church. Is there an emerging church in this house? We both generations are pregnant at the same time. And both pregnancies are supernatural. See, when you're truly pregnant, you don't have to announce it. When you're carrying a vision from God, you don't have to go and put it on Facebook. You don't have to announce a house that's on fire. People see the smoke. People see the flames. Oh, come on now. Come on now. It's okay if they think you're silly and stupid, but just open your mouth and see God respond to your voice.
Stop what you're doing and listen.
Five, four, three, two, one.
The title track, Supernatural, was born out of my desire to see stadiums full by the power of the Holy Ghost and to see people just come from different places. And the lyrics of the song is that we see the nations calling out, millions of people hungry for Jesus. What a day when we see millions of people hungry for Jesus. We see them falling on their knees. Thousands are taking to the streets. Angels ascending and descending. Imagine you pull back your curtains one morning and there's an open heaven and you see angels just ascending and descending from the throne of God. And then the glory of heaven is coming down. Millions around the world are changing into the image of God's Son.
Supernatural.
Come on, everybody.
Your glory is filling the earth.
We declare.
We declare rain greater than more than ever.
Revival generation.
Revival generation. People see dead men being raised up again. We're stepping out to the next time.
Supernatural Sea, I believe, is going to change the world. It's a new sound. It's a sound of revival. It's a sound of reformation. It's a sound of God's glory sweeping through the nations of the earth. And the Bible says, the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord like the waters cover the sea. One of my other favorite songs is Fill the Earth with Your Awesome Power. And it goes like this. From the north to the south, let your glory cover.
Your glory will come.
Your glory will cover the earth. just releasing a song. We are releasing God's song over the nation. We are speaking into airways. We are speaking over cities. We are speaking over territories. And God is releasing a new breed of passionate worshipers that will worship Him in spirit and in truth. That generations that will come after us will be singing what God has placed in their hearts. Are you ready? We are the people that will bring the sound. Are you ready to bring it? I am. Are you ready for the supernatural? We are. Come on, let's just get into the glory. Let's lift up new sounds, the frequency of heaven. Let's begin to pierce the atmosphere with a thunderous sound. That we can never touch God's heart if we cannot touch His heart through praise and worship. It takes a strong man to fall on his face and worship something that he cannot see. But we know that the power of praise and worship not only releases the glory of God on the earth, it also has the power to unlock the heavenlies. Everything that I preach, it's my message, it's my message to the world that there's a generation that God is raising up that will become everything that He has in His heart. This is that generation that the Bible spoke about, that will see dead raised, that will see blind eyes open, that will see the crippled walk. And I believe that we are that people.
This is that. Woo! Here we go! Thousands of people running into the space with hearts full of fire. The reason they left it up to another place. We're going higher. Thousands of people running into the space with hearts full of fire. The vision they left it up to another place. We're going. We're taking the vision to the. We've broken through, we make spirit connection. Is that
generations that will come after us will be singing what God has placed in their hearts. Are you ready? We are the people that will bring the sound. Are you ready to bring it? I am. Are you ready for the supernatural? We are. Come on, let's just get into the glory. Let's lift up new sounds, the frequency of heaven. Let's begin to pierce the atmosphere with the thunderous sound. It's time for Africa. I declare it's time for South Africa. I declare that our cities are erupting everywhere from the north to the south, to the east to the west with the spirit of revival. Get ready, get ready, get ready. God is about to shake the city. God is about to shake the earth. Kenako, now is the time.